The poor man say, All I can say, Brother Jerry, is when she thought I was an old man. I don't know what she said. When Faith thought I was an old man, I don't know what she thought about you, but older. But we love and appreciate our deacon. I'll tell you, he and Brother Emmett look around the maintenance of this church property and the outdoors, and Brother Jerry always has up-to-date flowers and stuff. It's just, in fact, when Brother Shaw was here for our, I think it was our homecoming, he commented to me how well the ground was kept and the flowers. And he said, it's not like that all over the state, brother. And we are blessed to have men that love the Lord. Because of the race, we will not be having service tonight, and probably a lot of people stayed home today, didn't want to maybe face the traffic. But Sister Gail, I agree with you. We are in for a special, special service this morning. I appreciate you having a prayer over the service at the end of your Sunday school lesson. Later on in the message, we're going to sing another song. I passed out the flyers for that. We have a video to go with it. I'm sure, Brother Curtis, you know how to play that song, don't you? Good, good. Because, well, we're going to have the video because it has slides with it. But later on, different times, we're going to be singing this. My message today, the title is, If That Isn't Love. The love of Christ. The love of Christ. God is love. Amen? And there is the Trinity. There is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In fact, sometimes we refer to it as God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever, as whosoever, believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And this week I've been thinking about the love of Christ. God loved us. But do you realize how much Christ loved us? He's the one that came. He left the splendor of heaven. Think about that. We talk about how beautiful heaven must be. And we talk about the, Sister Joan, the streets of gold and the walls of jasper and the other great stones and gates of pearl and all these things. And Jesus left it all to be born in a manger. Think of that. What a, talk about going from here to here. And throughout his ministry, he exemplified love. Even on the cross, he remembered the thief hanging by his side. Amen? Hanging on the cross, he loved the men that nailed him to the point where he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And I desire your prayers. I'm asking the Lord to help me get into certain scriptures. And Michael, I just know we won't be getting through them all. And at some time, I want you to go to that video. By the way, Dottie Rambo wrote this song, If That Isn't Love. And I was trying to think in my mind. We had a lady at our church in Erie, Pennsylvania. Her daughter was married to Jim Myers. And she came to church and wanted to sing a song. And I said, fine. What song do you want to sing? And this was a song she wanted to sing. But Sister Gail, she said, I'm not going to sing it alone. Preacher, you're going to have to sing with me. Now, I came totally unprepared that day, but God did bless. And I want to tell you just a little bit what happened last night before I get into my message. The only part of that song I could remember, he left the splendor of heaven. And I just was singing that over in my mind, and Brother Raymond, I just couldn't grasp the rest of the song. Of course, that was over 30 years ago. And sometimes when my muscles get sore, I go in the hot tub outside at nighttime. And I'm sitting there, and you know, one man turned his face to the wall and said, God, I want to live. I'm sort of paraphrasing this. I've been a sort of a good guy, and I want to live longer. Hezekiah, I believe it was. And God gave him 15 more years life. I'm in there, and I said, now, Lord, how am I going to find that song? Because he left the splendor of heaven was not the name of it. I knew it wasn't. And I'm sitting there, and all of a sudden it flowed. And I'm outside, and I'm just singing. I mean, I'm having church. And I didn't sing it once. I sang it about 8 times. And I thought I was being a little bit quiet. And when I went in the house, Faith said, "Oh, I heard you singing. Oh, it was beautiful," she said. But it just, I had church. Have you ever had church all by yourself? I went in and got onto my computer, and I wanted to find the words, and lo and behold, a guy by the name of Ray Bolts, I think his last name was, had a video with it. So I'm playing it, and Gina, tears are just coming down my cheeks. And I thought, oh, if that isn't love. The Bible says over in Ephesians, the 3rd chapter, verse 19, "And to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God." You will not be filled with the fullness of God until you know the love of Christ. And to know that love. "He died that I might have life and have it more abundantly. He suffered without the gate that I might be sanctified. And with his stripes, we not might be healed. We are healed." Past tense. He paid the price. Think of that. With his blood, shedding of his blood, is the gift of salvation. And to know that love. And it talks about knowledge. Christ, when he was 12 years old, Sister Joan, mystified the scholars. You know that he could have begun his ministry as far as knowledge at age 12? But you know what the law said? He couldn't be that young. He had to be 30. And so he brought himself under subjection to the law. Christ did not destroy the law. He fulfilled the law. He loved the Jewish people so much. And he came to seek and to save the lost sheep of Israel. And when they rejected, it was turned to the Gentile nations. If you know your Gospels, some of the greatest healings that were ever done were done through the Gentile nation. In fact, he would make comments such as, "I have not seen so much faith, no, not in all of Israel." And Christ loved people. When the woman was brought to him that was caught in the very act of adultery, and it is amazing the man wasn't there. If she's caught in the act, guess who was there? He was. Chances are he was somebody important, and they wanted to justify her. And they began to say, well, the law commands that she be stoned because there was 2 or 3 witnesses. You know what Jesus did? He got down and wrote in the sand. Now, I've heard a lot of people speculate, said, "Where's the man?" Okay. Or any number of things. But what impresses me, Brother Allen, is he got down on her level. To write in the sand, he got down and he began to write. And then he said, "He without sin casts the first stone." And they had, I can imagine the mob had stones in their hands ready to go. "You just say the word and we're going to stone her." And when he made that statement, "He without sin cast the first stone," I imagine the Spirit of God just got on them and said, "Oh, I just remember what I did here not long ago. Drop the stone. Drop the stone. Drop the stone." And when he looked up, he said, "Woman, where are thine accusers?" She said, "Lord, I have none." And in his love, he says, "Neither do I condemn thee, but go and sin no more." See, that's the love of God. And that very sin that she committed, he took and cast it into the sea of forgetfulness as though it never happened. Did it happen? Sure it did. Was she caught? Yes, she was. But most of all, she was forgiven. That's the love of Christ that passes understanding. He loves me so much that I am a joint heir with Christ. I want you to think about that. When time comes to split the inheritance, I'm joint heir. And the great thing about it is, I don't have to wait to get to heaven to share in His riches. Godliness with contentment is a great gain, all for the love of Christ, to flow fully through me, to be His hand extended. I can remember, you know, have you ever seen the old-fashioned crank phones? Is that what I'm talking about? Well, they had some wires in there. And if you get people to hold the wires, and then you crank that thing, there is a spirit flowing that will make them jump. And I can remember in high school that we brought one of those there, and we passed the wire around under the table. And then we asked some people to put their hands on our shoulder. And then somebody would crank that thing. And even though they didn't have direct contact with the wire, they still felt the juice flowing. There are people out there who do not have direct contact with Christ. But all may the love of Christ flow through me. That they want to be in my presence. That they can get within the presence of the Lord. The other day at Walmart, I was shopping, and one of the black cashiers, I know her, she came to my daughter's wedding, and we were laughing and carrying on, and one of the supervisors came by and said, "You must like her." I said, "Yes, I track her down, and she's not over here, she's here, I come where she is." And we were just laughing and carrying on, and said, "She's a great employee," and I'm just going on and on. And I looked at her and said, "Now, what else was I supposed to tell your boss?" And she just, you know, "Oh, don't do that," you know. Well, the Lord wants me to brag on Him. Amen? You know how I brag on Him? By living a Christian life. And by having that love flow through me. He loves me enough that He said, "I'm not His servant, but I'm His friend." Well, that's a love. If you love working where you work, it's not a job. Well, think about that. Have you ever been so overwhelmed where you had to physically toil sometimes? What happens is that it gets a little bit out of whack. But all of a sudden, you just ask the Lord to bless. I'm going to read some scriptures now in Philippians. There's about three or four slides with this one. It said, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men." You realize how much he dropped as far as being in heaven with his Father, around all those angels, and took on the form of man. And being found in a fashion as man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. You know, before Christ left heaven, he knew what his end would be and how his end would be. Because in the Garden of Gethsemane, it said that he prayed and asked his Father, "If it be possible, let this cup pass from me." He prayed to the extent, the Bible says, that his sweat became as great drops of blood. You know, you have what they call, I think, capillaries near the surface of your skin. And he must have prayed so earnestly and so intently that it must have broke some of those capillaries, because it said his sweat became as great drops of blood. The next slide, Michael. "Wherefore, God has highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name. There is no other name given under heaven whereby men must be saved." Some of the CDs that Hank and Mike and James and myself have listened to, it talked about a man who was asked to go to a... we have a National Day of Prayer coming up. It's posted back there on the bulletin board. I forget the exact date. It's May 4th, I believe, or 7th. And this event happened a while back. And they ask men of all different faiths to come and pray. And there was a man who prayed to Buddha, there was a man who prayed to Muhammad and Allah, and there was a man who prayed for this, that, and the other thing. And the last one was this man that we were listening to, and he got on the stage. He said, "I come to you in the name that is above all other names." And boy, they said the place just broke out for about 5 minutes, just praising God and rejoicing, because he is the name that is above all other names. There's been times that in a moment of great need, I said, "In the name of Jesus," that's the most powerful name you can utter. Think about that. In the name of Jesus. If you're ever around a demon possession thing, you better know the name of Jesus. Amen. Don't you try to do it in your own self, because seven sons of Sceva tried to do that, and you know what happened to them. We need to find a place, by God, that we know that name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, or things in heaven, and things in earth, and things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Not to glorify Christ, but Father. Think about that. You know, if you have the love of Christ in you, you are not out for self-edification. Amen and amen. The Bible talks about our work and our labor. It says, "Let all things be done for the edifying of" what? "The body of Christ." Not for any self-honor or any self-glory. The next slide, Michael, if you will. "Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not only in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling." You know, if you love Christ, you won't look for an excuse to do something that you ought not to do. Amen and amen. It's like a story I heard a long time ago. In the wild, wild west, they were trying to hire a stagecoach driver, and they had 3 men apply. And so they were talking, and there was a very narrow pass that the stagecoach had to go around the mountain, and it was a great crevice, a canyon, that if they missed, it would go down over. And back then, they didn't have guardrails. And so they interviewed the 3 men, and they said, the first guy, "How close can you get without going over?" He said, "I think I can get within 3 feet of that without going over." They asked the second person. He said, "I think I can get within a foot and not go over." And they asked the third guy, and he says, "Well, I don't know how close I can get, but I know one thing, I'll get as far away from possible when I drive." He got the job. See, if we're not careful, the devil tries to get us to see how close we can get to the edge without going over. If you love the Lord, you won't worry about getting as close as you can possibly get and still be right in the sight of God. Righteousness is right standing in the sight of God. Now, you know, I'm very careful. You know, I have bifocals, and when I first got them, my depth perception was off. And I went to Community Services Board over there on Clay Street, and they had these oak steps, you know, that go down. And I looked, and I went like this. And I almost went head over heels down them because my perception was off. So you know what I did? I went like this and walked down. You might say, "Well, didn't you look foolish?" No, I looked safe. I looked safe. Sometimes, in the love of God, the devil will try to say, "Oh, you love Christ so much, and look how foolish you look." No, I feel safe in his arms. I feel safe when the Spirit of God begins to move all over the place. And it says, "For it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure." Now, I went ahead and put these last scriptures in. "Do all things without murmuring and disputing." We have ever needed to pray for our country. We need to pray for it now. There is such a divide. And it's like, "Well, if you do this, I'm going to oppose it." Da, 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 on and on. And I'm thinking, whoa, all of you are there for the good of the people. What has happened that we are in such turmoil? You know what's happened? We're coming to the end of time. We need to wake up, church. We need to realize that Christ loves us. But even he has a limitation of what he will accept. It said that you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shall shine as lights in the world. And we will hardly even shine if we do not have the love of Christ in us. We need that love of Christ. Brother Michael, if you'll get ready for that slide, please. These other scriptures can wait. As I was singing last night in the hot tub, you might say, you know, I can be driving down the road. Sister Graham, I'm sure you've had church in your car as you've traveled. We went to Blacksburg yesterday. Jacob, our grandson, was speaking at a thing. There were six speakers, I think. And my wife printed directions on MapQuest. And the computer gave her the directions you talked about the other day, going down Shooting Creek and this place and that place. And I looked at Faye and I said, oh, honey, we don't want to do that. So I changed the route. It was 30 miles further and only 7 minutes longer. And I said, that's the route we're going to take. The love of Christ, his way, his yoke is easy and his burden is light. If all of a sudden you living your Christian life is almost unbearable and it's horrible, get off that route. Change your route. Get directions from the Lord. Let his love lead you and guide you and comfort you. But as I was singing that in my mind, I thought, I got a great-granddaughter coming, and I cannot wait for the time. I looked at Delilah and I say, honey, how much do you love Grandpapa? And I wanted to go, right? You want that from Noah and Wesley, don't you? How much do you love Papa? You know what? That's how much Jesus loved you. He stretched out his arms on Calvary. No man took his life. He laid down on that cross. And as they drove the nails, he knew the punishment was coming. But he loved me enough. And as I was having church in the hot tub, I saw us singing the song. But when I saw the video, I saw us doing the video. And then I saw us looking at each other and say, Jesus loves you. This much. I wish this house were full tonight. But you know what? We that are here need to know the love of Christ. We have to have that passes all knowledge. He is more than my Savior. He's my Lord. Amen? Michael, if you'll start that, and if you get your sheets, I want us to listen to this. And if you feel impressed to look to somebody, in fact, it wouldn't hurt, look at somebody and say, at the end, Jesus loves you this much.
He left the splendor. Was the lonely hill up there to lay down his life, there to lay down his life for me. If that isn't love, the ocean is dry, there are no stars in the sky, there are no stars in the sky. Spoke with love and compassion.
Glory to God. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, look down upon us right now. Help us to know the love of Christ that passes all knowledge. Lord, may it burn deep within us. Cause us, Lord, to be your hand extended in the day and time that we're living in. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for this church. Thank you, Lord, for y'all. Y'all are a woman. God is love.
Yes, he is.